Hello everyone, this is Princescyther and I'm with Raiko playing Splinter Cell Blacklist on the PS3. Yeah, there is. We tried doing this before, but we had some technical difficulties, so we're going to do it again. So, yeah, David has this on the Wii U, right?
I do indeed, and it's pretty fun.
I have it on the PS3, but I've just ordered the Wii U version. It's in the post off eBay. I got the special edition version. Is that anything special?
You get some free DLC, but we're talking
minimal.
I don't know, maybe a level and a gun or something.
Yeah, right. Oh well, they didn't really specify what it was, but over here, you can only get it in Walmart. You can't get it anywhere else.
That's very odd.
It's really annoying because our Walmart sold out in like a day or something. The woman said. I was like, oh, okay. Fair enough.
That's surprising.
Back to the game, anyway. Well, I live in the middle of nowhere, so maybe they didn't get many in. So, anyway. What's the story, David? Do you remember?
I think you're going to have to lead on this one. You know what? Video game stories. Bunch of guys get upset and go shooting.
That's it. Bunch of guys get upset and go shooting. So, there's a group out there called the Engineers, who are a bit, like, anonymous. Kind of a bit whingy.
They're not terrorists. I don't think anonymous are going to go around.
No, not in a terrorist sect. But like the way they show themselves and stuff, they produce little videos and stuff like that. Basically, the Engineers are threatening America. They're saying if you don't get your troops out of the other countries within a certain time limit, we'll start attacking you. And there's like 7 attacks, but they're all sort of cryptic. So it's like American consumption and American supply and things like that. I don't know if American supply is one actually, but so yeah. So since there's no third echelon anymore because it's been disbanded, the president of the United States gets possibly the worst team together ever to create fourth echelon, which is commanded by Sam Fisher, the regular man. And it's up to us to stop the engineers from attacking in time. Is that a good synopsis, Dave? Does that make sense?
That's pretty good. That's pretty detailed. That sounds like you wrote that down just before.
No. I just remember it. It's not a very complicated storyline, so it kind of makes sense. But yeah, basically, that guy there is a dick. That's Charlie, the one they just left there. He's a dickhead. He's the IT guy. So the team's made up of 4 people. It's made up of Sam Fisher, who's the commander. Grimm's daughter, who is... I used to think Grimm's daughter was like the daughter of someone. Let's go. Back in the day, back in like the first 3 games, I always say, oh, Grimm's daughter. I thought, oh, who's this Grimm guy that we're missing out? But it's not, it's just her weird sort of Germanic name. That guy there is, what's his name? I can't remember his name. Vic. He's Sam Fisher's mate. They used to work together in the war, back in the war days. But he doesn't last very long, as you're about to see in a little while. But yeah, as I was saying, you got Grimm's daughter, who is kind of in command as well. You got Briggs, who is like support. He supports Sam with like guns and stuff. And then you got Charlie, who's the IT guy. He gets all the intel and stuff. But they basically all hate each other, so it doesn't make too much sense. Leave him. So there's the leader of the gang there, just walking past. Leader of the engineers. Sounds a bit British.
Does a bit. That's because we're bad guys, man.
Bad guys. We are stereotypically the bad guys in a lot of movies and games, aren't we?
We are indeed.
Because we're so well spoken, I guess.
What is it? In a Killzone, in the English version, it's Danish people who are bad guys. But in every other version in the world, it's English.
Is it?
That's funny. The Hellcast have like English accents everywhere else, but in our version it's all like Danish or whatever.
You can never really understand what the fucking Hellcast are saying. She's like, run, run, run! And like throwing grenades or whatever. Get out! It's pretty crazy. They're all like Darth Vader. I'm not sure how Vic and Sam survived this fucking helicopter crash. That is insane. So yeah. They just blew up Anderson's airbase to prove a point, I guess.
Not even a scratch on him, unfortunately.
No, just outside the absolutely grill. Fine.
Shake a leg.
Shake a leg.
We're a big target out here. You can't, Vic. It's trapped.
That's the new stop. Voice of Sam Fisher. I can't, Vic. It's trapped. So yeah, they've changed the voice. It's no longer what's his name? I can never remember his name. Ironside. It's not him anymore.
Michael Ironside. Yeah.
They replaced him due to the fact that they wanted the guy to do the mocap and the voice at the same time. The same reason why David Hayter's been replaced. But actually, that's not true, because in Metal Gear Solid 5, in Japan, the mocap's being done by the same guy that does the voice. But over here, it's, what's his name, out of 24, who's done no mocap, I don't think.
Keeper Sutherland.
Yeah. That's what I do. Weird.
Well, yeah, they're not going to use motion capture twice, are they?
No, so what's the point of replacing him?
Probably because Kiefer Sutherland has a better voice, a more realistic voice.
Don't have a laugh!
Like, don't get me wrong, Snake's voice is quite iconic, but it's quite weird.
It's grovelly.
Yeah, but overly so. He sounds like a wrestler overacting or something.
But you can't blame him for that. You can blame the director, Chris Zimmerman. Yeah. You can blame her. Now they fixed it.
Apparently, the voice he auditioned with was different to the voice he ended up going with.
Oh, really?
So, yeah, so.
Are you talking about Kiefer Sutherland or are you talking about Hayter?
Hayter.
Oh, right. They felt cheated.
They were like, after four games, they were like, hold on a minute. We just seen your audition tape. This is nothing like that, mate. Nothing. Don't move. That's a Japanese Cockney accent there.
Yeah. Ah, shit. So, back to this game anyway. This is kind of like the tutorial level. Quick, give me a
booster. The pre-menu level.
Yeah, much. Which you can actually skip if you press... I think you press start and it just gives you an option. But yeah, you can skip it. This is weird. Give him a boost, but then climb up yourself.
Even though you're the one with the trapped...
Yeah, we were the one that got trapped under.
But yeah, as soon as you climb over this wall, your leg's fine, so...
That's it. Dee-dee-dee. Back to normal again. So this is all kind of done for me here. I am moving it slightly, but the camera sort of does get sucked into a position.
Into place, yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of annoying. And they still have that problem. You see how I grab him here in a second? When, like, it's still... When I press square, he sort of slides towards me slightly. They still have that kind of problem. Which I guess is kind of hard to stop, really.
Yeah. I do like this cover system, but I've got to say, one button is enough, man. Why do you need to press one button to cling to a wall, and then another button to change, and then another button to get off?
Yeah, I guess...
I kind of get it, but at the same time, man, it's still a bit...
They could have just used circle and then circle to also move, I guess, couldn't they?
Yeah. One button to snap to a wall and then point and aim at the next wall and use the same button.
Because when you come off of a wall, do you press circle? Because I don't. I just sort of move my joystick away from the wall.
I think I do that. Like, it's more convenient to use the button, but naturally I tend to pull away from the wall.
Yeah.
That's the more natural thing.
Can you try and get through without being seen? Can I do it? Can I do it? No! Ah! Oh, well, saved by a cutscene.
Why is he asking for help?
Help me!
He looks fine.
Just dragging him.
That's what you do, man. Imagine it was his arm that was hanging off and like Sam just pulled it off.
Oh, man.
Oh, God, sorry, mate. Honestly,
what like left for dead or something like this. I'm working on it.
How's the kid? Don't ask. You can't stop the blacklist.
Alright, alright. All you need to do is disable the voltage oscillator and disrupt the competing signal.
Just hold still. No talk, okay?
Charlie, how about an on-off switch?
Do you see a blue button?
Yeah.
Hit it.
What are you saying?
Would something that size have one button that just shuts it down? Like that? Surely it would, like, you'd need some sort of fail-safe, sorry, just in case someone accidentally does press it when you don't want them to. Here's that cool little interface where you have to do some curling to get something to open.
There should be a bunch of virtual skittles at the end that you have to knock down. Otherwise it doesn't load what you want.
Doesn't make any sense.
It's just very flashy. Look, that's the inverted YouTube. That's the YouTube channel inverted.
If I use black, I use a black YouTube.
No, but I mean the white. Do you? I mean, like, yeah. The white screen is black, and then the red bar is blue. And
that's what I use. But well, I don't use blue. I don't. It's not blue, but the background's black. America. This is the Blacklist. Here we go. One new attack every 7 days. We have one demand. You have soldiers in 153
countries. Bring your troops home. Why does the video have to be all flashy and artsy?
Yeah, I tell you, it's like anonymous, you see. It's all over the show.
Why not just record yourself or just record a voice message and that's it?
Yeah, it doesn't make much sense because later on he's more than happy to go in front of the camera. So what's the point of hiding yourself now?
It looks like a promo for a music album or something. We are the engineers.
Here we go, that woman president. But we can't locate Mr. Fisher. His friend is fighting for his life. So modern. Find Sam. Hundreds dead in Guam, a countdown to more attacks targeting America. You'll start to see why I think this team is probably the worst team put together ever. In a moment when they start arguing with each other.
Yeah, it's a bit of a shame that they're just a bunch of idiots.
They just don't like each other. Poor, like, you have to feel sorry for Briggs, who's sort of chucked in there, and he just gets ignored.
Briggs.
Yeah, like, he tries asking a question in a minute. There he is. He tries asking a question, and Sam's like, whatever, moving on. He says, Briggs, you're coming with me, and then Briggs is like, what, do you want me to just support you, or am I taking anyone down? And then Sam just moves on. He's like, Sam, that's a question that needs answering, really. He needs to know what his role is.
As The Rock would say, know your role.
Exactly, know your role. And there's Charlie being a dick.
It's pretty sweet, right? First time in a plane. No?
Look at his huge eyes.
A debris with the Sanctuary's organization.
Nothing yet. Briggs and our contacts are isolating probable candidates.
What about the names? American Freedom, American Blood.
Potential attacks.
For motion capture, it looks a bit odd.
Yeah. 5 days. Still looks a bit robotic.
It does, and it doesn't look like they're looking at anything particular, and their eyes wander so weirdly.
Yeah, their eyes move around a lot.
Now this, this being the hub of the entire game between missions, I despise this now.
Yeah, there's no menu here, you just use this little plane area to wander around, which takes longer than a menu, if you've got honest.
It kind of reminds me of the battleship in Final Fantasy VII that you get. You can go inside it, but that was quite fun. There wasn't a lot to do, but it didn't take a long time to navigate. It
wasn't mandatory either.
No, and if you needed a menu, there was a single menu button straight away.
Yeah, exactly. NSA, DCS,
FBI, all in real time. This is just way too flashy. It's a nice idea in theory, but we've made significant improvements since the early system Charlie worked on. I'll let him get you. And it gets its own cutscene to introduce it as well. You can control everything from right
here or from your OPSAT when you're on the ground. It's not very green. Impressive. Having a plane this size flying around in the sky the whole time cannot be good.
Thanks, Charlie.
The amount of petrol they're using.
Greenpeace must be like chasing them.
They're pissed off with four fashion. Hey, Sam. So you can see, go to Grim to update your plane. You can go to Charlie to buy weapons and stuff. And you can also go to Charlie and Briggs. Can you not for missions? Can't really remember.
Yeah.
Oh, you can even go to her for missions there.
You can do, and you can also. I won't spoil it, but there is someone else you can speak to.
Don't ruin it for me.
Loading data.
Hey, Sam. Almost forgot. You're upset.
Oh yeah, the loading times in this game are absolute shit. They take forever. So I've edited them down a little bit. Control, scanning. Gotcha.
All you gotta do is although I never noticed any loading screens on cutscenes. Like that one.
Like
I don't
the one
remember
between
that,
the two.
Bit of calibration.
Yeah, just making sure I can see the screen. This is basically how you pick missions and stuff.
A protester outside a U.S. military installation in Ansbach, Germany, was shot and injured this morning by a sentry who thought the man was a possible threat. Gunter Schmidt, 34, was hit twice in the leg as he approached the base's front gate, despite repeated warnings to stop. U.S. bases around the world have been on high alert following the so-called Blacklist attack.
The so-called?
Yeah.
I like the money in this game. At first, I thought it was just chucking it at you.
Yeah, there is.
There is actually quite a bit to upgrade, and they could have probably removed a couple of the noughts, but might not have been realistic. But it would have.
Yeah, it is a little bit like African currency, isn't it? You get like 42 grand for like one mission or something.
Yeah.
Or 42 million, sorry, for one mission.
That's how they keep the plane in the air. They can actually afford someone to keep landing and getting fuel and coming back to them. He's paying them this money, goddammit.
There's something you're not telling me.
See, look, they're withholding information. Andre Coben, does that mean anything? Yeah, Andre Coben.
Sam.
Whoa, wait. We know this guy.
What we need to know is what would make a wanted arms dealer turn himself into the CIA right after Guam.
All due respect, why don't we just leave the interrogation to the CIA?
You can forget the bullshit.
Thinking back to the old Splinter Cells, especially like the first two.
Am I missing something?
Yeah.
These are only it was all about the like sort of mission, really. There wasn't some sort of Who is Andre personal Coben? Thing.
Andre Coben.
Well, there was an overall story to that, to them.
There was, but it just like even then it was a little more like it drove the game. Whereas some of this is just nonsense.
What's our move?
It does feel like they're trying to make a film out of it. There's a lot.
Well, that's the way of games, though, isn't it? We're trying to be movies nowadays. I don't like that. I hate that. Ugh, annoys me.
Do you want to start this mission or do you want to go back and
Why give me the option? I've chosen the mission. Why would I not want to go? The CIA tries to keep their Middle East ops super obvious. See that Charlie being a dick. Your best approach is through the bazaar. This is when Briggs is about to ask a question and he just gets blanked. It'll be a clear run at
Coben. It always looks easy on a screen, Graham.
To be clear, Sam, we are talking about an extraction, not killing him.
You're up. Show me viable positions for Overwatch.
Best sight lines are here and there.
Looks good. Grab a suppressed sniper kit.
Am I providing cover or am I taking out the targets?
Charlie, Russell's...
Answer him! He needs to know! That's a valid question.
You just worry about a viable spot for
He's just like, whatever.
Everyone clear?
Solid Sam.
Still sounds like a gay porn name.
Flight deck. Vicious snake. Benghazi.
Grim says you gotta keep Coben alive. So yeah,
look how he poses.
You don't have to go to Charlie to upgrade your stuff. You can just upgrade it from the just before the mission starts, which is really good. Because I hated running up to him every mission, because I didn't know. I forgot you could do this. Upgrading me stuff. As you can see, I'm going for accuracy rather than anything else.
There's some sort of appeal to doing this, but really it isn't necessary either, is it?
Not really.
Not something I thought was lacking in older Splinter Cell games. But, I don't know.
I think making your outfit more stealthy is a pretty good idea.
We've got a problem.
But I don't really use the pistol anyway, as you know. I use the stun gun.
Briggs, you have a visual on the safe house.
Quite a big fan of these opening couple of levels.
During the day, out in the open, multiple routes. Militia's blocking the front
door access. They're still not on par with Chaos Theory, which was just like one area, but you could tackle it almost any way you wanted. Which is quite nice.
Keep trying to reach our contact. Let me know if you get through. Copy.
This goes back to more traditional Splinter Cell, in which case it's almost like A to B, but with multiple routes in.
Yeah.
Whereas Chaos Theory was just go in any way you can.
It's like if you picture a straight line, but with like an 8 shape in the middle. It's like that. Kind of like there's still an end and a beginning, but you have to go through this 8 shape. And you can go left, right, center, basically. See, we're going to the bathroom. I still question whether this is the bathroom or not. It's got a sink in it.
But they couldn't afford to model the toilet, so
getting into his little outfit.
like in the music.
Bum bum.
Still moving, Sam.
Rats on the floor. Yeah, so in this game you have a stun gun, which is cool. You didn't have a stun gun in Conviction, did you?
I don't know if you did. I never ever used it.
It reminds me more of the M5 from Metal Gear Solid anyway, the gun that puts them to sleep and stuff. It has that sort of effect, although you get a lot less ammo in this game.
But you don't have to be as precise. You can just shoot someone in the back, chest, knee.
Yeah, you can shoot them anywhere.
Just, like, knocks them out straight away.
Yeah, you can even hit them in the water. If you hit the water, you can send them to sleep too.
That's quite cool.
So this is annoying. We just did a fucking tutorial level, and now it's more tutorial. So I'm not like, I'm trying to control this, but I can't do it. It keeps swinging me around. There you go. As soon as these guys get done, then you're back to just being me again.
It's a bit of a shame it forces that on you every time you play this mission as well.
Yeah, it's really annoying, isn't it? No need to go in there.
Something I missed that I thought was a nice touch, rather than having your lights on your costume go green, was the black and white visuals when you were in shadow.
Yeah.
I like that. I thought that was a really good idea. You've got multiple targets ahead. One on the balcony. These are viable stuff. I think people complained.
That ain't Splinter Shell, man. That ain't what Splinter Shell's all about.
So I'm trying to attract this guy, although, as you said before, you can actually go through there and they won't see you. But I prefer to get him over and give him a little drag. Pull him in. Poof.
Oof.
Smash.
You know what would be funny is if that didn't actually knock him out. About just 3 seconds later, he's just like, ow!
Get back up again. That can be. This can be a little bit weird too sometimes. His climbing can be a little bit annoying. Like, you can press right, and for some reason he might go up rather than just straight right. Like back you saw me, I climbed back up the window for some reason when I obviously didn't want to do that.
I tell you, the amount of times in this game alone that I've jumped through windows that aren't open when I'm trying to open them and things like that.
Hmm. Don't know why
or
I do this.
Shut a window and then jump through it.
Oh yeah, so you smash it out.
Yeah. Sam's just a crazy bastard.
You hear him breathing.
You know what would have been good if they had, you know the you know how you beat people up in Conviction, you smashed them off pianos and desks.
During the interrogation.
If you could do that, if you could knock somebody out, and depending on where they're standing, you'd use that to help. So you just, rather than strangle them or whatever, you smash their head off something.
But then again, it's a lot quieter though, isn't it?
it'd be all out noise, but if that's the way you want it to play.
Some of the characters in this game are still blind as shit. Like, you can stand right in front of them and take someone out sometimes, and they're still like, what? Didn't see nothing.
They do need to be, to some extent, unfortunately.
They do, but at the same time...
But yeah, it's still poor game design in that sense.
Bluff.
Nice work securing the package. Roger that. I like the little thing that comes up at the bottom, where you get points for... Like, I think I managed to take out... I managed to knock out 5 people with a sticky camera the other... In one go, and that popped up, which was quite nice. I think that was one of the challenges as well. For, like, Ghost or something. Or Panther, I don't know. Alright, Charlie, I'm patched.
Okay, yes. Yes. Done. Wow, there is a
lot of freaky porn on here. We're looking for a location. Right, I
traced the call. See, his mind's wandering again.
Charlie's light humor.
Yeah.
Not funny. Roger
that. When Sam's like in the middle of a fucking war zone. Enemy transport dropping hostiles, at least a dozen. Moving now. I'll cover your exit. We're off.
This definitely has a sort of. It reminds me of Time Splitters in that the first couple of levels seem to have the most attention to detail.
You think the developers just got lazy towards the end?
Or just ran out of time.
Well, saying that, you've not actually played it to the end.
I haven't, but as it's gone on, done the first five.
Yeah.
And the first two, distinctly, like.
Just leave them alone.
Interesting.
I think there's 12 missions in all, so you still got 7 to go.
I'm uploading a shortcut to the police station. It'll be on your
These little boxes hanging around.
So yeah, I'm trying to time this when you first do it and you know it's obviously what you've got to do.
Yeah, yeah.
Not knowing when to press it and then going over his head.
I didn't have the problem with not knowing when to do it. I had the problem of what button I had to press. I wasn't sure which button. Because I wanted to press circle. But then it's square. And I don't know why. Weird. I don't know.
So you go, all that effort to knock him out. Did you know that actually kills them?
Oh, does it?
Yeah, so if you're trying to do a playthrough where you're not killing anyone.
Trying to do ghost or something.
Yeah, then chucking them off is a bad move.
Oh well.
But it's quite funny.
I suppose it makes sense that they do die. It's quite high up. So I'm just waiting for someone to come up here. Because I can never really get their pattern down there, so I always just sort of let them come to me. They're always a bit spread out down there, so it's always there's always a high risk of getting seen.
I choose not to recognise a pattern. I don't know why.
What do you mean?
Like, I don't sit and watch them for too long.
Oh, right.
Like, to see what they're going to do and try and remember for next time or anything. Well, it's just a case of...
The patterns are quite varied here. I mean, there is obviously one in there. Well, thinking about it, they do seem to move around quite randomly, so maybe there's not much of a pattern. But there must be a pattern in there somewhere, because otherwise the AI might just walk off the edge or something. But, yeah, I mean, I don't generally wait for a pattern, but because it takes a long time to see it, but yeah.
Yeah.
Just let him come to me. That's the plan. Like this little silly sod.
Now you got two guns, and one of them's standing up. Oh, I keep reading KOs as a kid's for some reason.
Oh,
so
yeah.
Like it said you got 10,000 like for abduction kits.
As you can see, I'm just trying to figure out which way these people are going to go. Guy on the left would have seen me, see if I would have jumped down there too soon.
I come down this way, but I go through the door behind you.
Where does that lead?
Well, no, that's where I come out. The door upstairs leads to
down there, okay.
So I do that. By the time I get down there, there's no one there.
It didn't go red.
Sky went green then for a second.
Yeah, it did. No, it did. As I said, I think my hard drive was about to blow up when I was playing this for some reason. I tried streaming it live on YouTube and it just kept crashing on me for some reason. I don't know if my PS3 was just getting really hot. But I managed to get through it anyway. Didn't go red, I'm good.
It's still good.
I used to think that when it starts beeping that means that you've been seen to the point of, you know, that's it kind of thing.
Yeah.
But it doesn't. When it goes red, it means that.
His animation up against the wall just looks really dodgy.
Single digits on Langley's most wanted. If you capture him, we'll arrange for pickup.
Mask on red. How much is Coben worth? But luckily, there's no one around to save him.
HVT secured. I tell you, one of Charlie's missions where you have like 3 minutes to capture two people while there. There's about like 8 or 9 of them wandering around with guns. That is a bitch.
I don't really like the ones where you have to sort of hold out for like the waves of people to come. I prefer the ones where you have to get into somewhere and plant some stuff on the routers and then get back out again. Those ones I think are a lot better, where you have to get into somewhere without being seen and get out without being seen.
Yeah.
They're a lot better than the wave ones. I've not actually done one where you have to go in there and get someone.
Oh no, this is part of the wave ones. It's just like rather than just taking them all out, there's two people you need to capture, and you've got a time limit in which to do it.
Okay.
So you get like 2 minutes to do it, so you have to rush to get them out of the way.
I'm a little bit nervous about playing it on the Wii U. I'm so used to the wheel. Can you use the wheel still?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, that's all right.
You can use the Pro Controller for this as well, so...
I don't have a Pro Controller. I have a Wii Pro Controller. Will that work?
Classic. No, I don't think so. I can check the manual for you, but I'm sure it says no. I tell you, I'm quite gutted about that Wii U update not allowing you to play anything on the gamepad.
Yeah, exactly. What's the point? You just have to like lay the gamepad against a wall or something and use it as a small TV.
Apparently, some people have done that already. Like, most people were outraged, thinking, well, what's the point in this? And then like a couple of people were like, oh, well, I do that, actually.
What's the point in it? How are you meant to do it if it's like a game where you need to use a sensor bar?
Sensor bar on the controller.
Sensor bar on the controller?
Yeah, the top of the controller where the camera is. There's a sensor bar.
Is it?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's... Do you remember that tech demo of the Golf before the Wii U came out?
And oh, there was the screen.
You were meant to use the sensor bar on the controller and the TV at the same time.
Oh.
For like extra precision, so like your Wii remote had to line up with the ball on the screen perfectly, otherwise you knocked it off sideways.
Oh, here's a new addition to this game. Sorry, mate. The dogs. There's new dogs, doggies that you don't see in any other Splinter Cell game. I don't think. Is there any animals in the past ones? I don't think there is.
I'm not sure. I don't want to say no.
Yeah, but I'm rethinking it as well now. I know there's dogs in Metal Gear Solid 3. That's the first. And Metal Gear Solid 1, actually.
I think there is, you know. I think there is. I'm immediately thinking of Pandora Tomorrow.
Hmm. Maybe there is.
The jungle sort of levels. I'm pretty sure there is.
I don't really remember much, to be honest, about Pandora Tomorrow. I remember a lot of... I remember like a train level. You're on top of a train.
I enjoyed it at the time, but as soon as I played Chaos Theory...
Ah, Chaos Theory kicked it out of the water. Chaos Theory was amazing.
Chaos Theory was so good that it made the first two quite redundant. I couldn't play them again.
Yeah.
I literally
Especially
couldn't
the
play
first
them.
One is, like, really hard to play now. I got the HD collection for the PS3, and the first one is just terrible to play. The gameplay mechanics are just awful. The graphics still look quite good, with the lighting and stuff. But, oh, man. Awful. Yeah, here comes a man.
That was a series like Prince of Persia that I bought all in one go to play through.
Yeah, I got the Prince of Persia HD collection too. Boodoo. Whoa, that was so close.
It's annoying that when you haven't got the radar when you first play through this, you have no idea what's over that wall. And you think, oh, look, climb. So maybe I'll hang on the edge of it rather than leap over the top.
Rather than jump straight over, yeah.
But no.
Oh, he was just about to walk away. Go away, doggies.
I went through the door rather than over the roof.
Yeah.
It all works.
It's okay, I get saved by the halfway door. Done, knocked him out, done.
Magic.
So you get to this point, you kind of, if there is anything you wanted back there, there's no way to get him anymore. You can't get him. Can't get back out of that cage door.
Alright, calm down.
Yeah, you can hear Andre Cobin getting raped.
Or he's on the toilet and he's doing some pretty damning things.
Yeah. Talking about Chaos Theory and the jump, actually. Chaos Theory was great and everything, but I reckon they did a really good job with Conviction. Like the new gameplay mechanics and stuff, which we see here now.
Yeah, no. I think the mechanics.
You weren't a fan of it to start with, I remember. Because there was, there was too many buttons for you to like.
Again, you do get used to it.
But I just thought it flowed really well. I thought it was like playing parkour game or something. He just like moves really well, I think. compared to the way he used to. He was pretty stiff on the older games, but now he sort of moves a lot more fluid. And forget it, what's the other one called where he goes to jail and stuff? Because that game's fucking wank.
Double Agent.
Yeah, that game was terrible. I hated that. And I tried playing it so many times, like, I'd come back, like, I'd play it thinking, oh, this is crap. And then I'd think about it, go, oh, maybe it wasn't that bad, I'll go back to it. Go back to it, it was still crap. Like, oh, it really annoyed me that game was so bad.
Why did you run to the Americans?
I told you, it has nothing to do with you. Nothing, I swear to God!
Oh. It's like that Grand Theft Auto 5 torture scene that everyone's going mad about.
Well, that's not what everyone's going mad about now. Everyone's going mad about their saves being corrupted.
How are they?
Trying to get online.
You talk too much.
The online sounds quite good.
Don't think it gets you in trouble.
I love this scene, shooting through the glass.
Fucking told them everything, okay?
I've located Coben.
Is he alive?
For now.
For now.
There's that bit where you didn't bother doing this, you just went in there, didn't you? Firing?
Yeah, first time. But second time, I grabbed the first guy through the window.
Oh, yeah.
So like, I smashed through the window with my arms. And pulled it. Like something out of Batman.
Oh, you have got to be fucking shitting me.
Look at him bouncing away.
Fisher, this is about what happened in DC.
Shut up.
Sam, what's
happening? No, don't.
There you go. Vic was right, wasn't he? He did need that knife. In the first tutorial mission, he's like, oh, I don't need that knife. If I need that knife, then something's gone wrong.
You here to save me?
Give Coben a piggyback while Coben's tied to a chair.
Do you know, I'd prefer it if he gave him a fucking piggyback, rather than having to drag him out.
Yeah, these bits are a bit crunk.
Yeah, it makes it really annoying. Makes your body size like twice the size it is, so it's really hard to hide behind anything. You can't like go against a wall or anything like that.
You'll keep me safe, right?
And if you get seen here, it's oh my god, it's so hard. When the reinforcements come, it's so hard not to die.
Oh, you don't swap shoulder at all, do you?
No. I actually couldn't figure out how to do that, I'll be honest.
Well, it says it, and it's been saying it on the screen for about 15 seconds.
Oh, yeah.
Swap
I
shoulder.
I missed it. I just couldn't do it. I even remember in later missions thinking, I really wish I could swap my controller, but I just can't remember. So you'll watch this, and I don't think I change it once, unless I accidentally do it.
Shit.
Yeah, that's down, that's good. Now the reinforcements won't come. You know, you've never played it when the reinforcements come, have you? You've always managed to make it through.
Yeah, I've always done it. It's been easy.
Yeah, you wait until the reinforcements come when you play it on hard or something. Jesus Christ. There's like, because they come from this way and the way I just was, and in here it seems like there's a lot of places you can hide, but they run really close to you, so it's really hard to like find a place to hide behind.
What are you kidding me? I'm not even wearing shoes.
Move.
It always makes me wince. I just the idea of shoes, no shoes on, and when he sort of falls on top of the van and then on the floor, I keep thinking he's just gonna like hit the concrete like a toe punt downwards. Ah, it annoys me.
I'm surprised he hasn't let go already. If he doesn't know what he's about to do, then he wouldn't have held onto the belt too tightly. Sam just pushes him off the building and kills him.
What's Sam using there? What's he using?
I don't know, he carries it on him though quite a lot.
Yeah.
Don't know, it's like a bicycle handlebar.
Yeah.
That's pretty much it, he nicked it.
Look at Charlie's face, what's he smiling about?
Talk.
Alright. 6 weeks ago, a client contacted me. He wanted small arms, Katushas, a fucking missile launcher, you name it. He was willing to pay top dollar, too. It was a good deal. It was too good.
Too good.
You supplied weapons for Blacklist Zero?
Hey, I supply a lot of people, okay? They don't usually go around targeting U.S. bases.
Who was it?
All I know is that they were talking about the attack on the embassy in Vienna, like they were fucking proud of it.
Hundreds of innocent people died in that attack.
Yeah, no shit! That's what I'm saying! This guy is a monster. He's a fucking ghoul, okay? And he doesn't leave loose ends.
Yikes. Shitty week. Am I right? This guy.
Shut up, Charlie.
Charlie is a punch.
Fucking idiot.
Who the fuck is this guy?
Exactly, Corbin. Exactly. Who the fuck is this guy? keep you idiots from killing Grimm could one, do man. His job. Like, Grimm does nothing.
Briggs, how do you feel about storing our new cargo?
My pleasure.
What does that mean?
Means they're putting you in a box and taping it up.
You and Charlie trying to dig up any information you can about Coben's mystery customer. It's time to go hunting.
Ooh, time to go hunting. Well, that's the first mission, guys. Thanks a lot for watching. And we'll see you next time in Insurgent Something, Stronghold.